Thank you. I don't have a proper presentation, but I can explain like this. I'm from Pakistan. Madam Leo showed the map of the world in showing the origin of rice cultivation. And I was seeing the Indus Valley civilization. So I'm from Indus civilization, currently in Pakistan. We have like 5-6 different major rice dishes which are very popular among the whole subcontinent, in Pakistan, in India, in Bangladesh also. So I will not talk about all, but only one, which is the most famous one. The most famous one is called biryani in our language. The same word is used in India, in Bangladesh also, in Nepal also. The whole region shares that, those 5-6 dishes. Because previously, before like 60 years, Pakistan and India and Bangladesh all were one subcontinent. So they are like parts of the same region. So they share the dishes. I don't know, my Indian friend from the previous session, I don't know what dish he explained, but I will talk about biryani. It is a rice dish made with chicken and a lot of spices. So you can consider it as a kind of a spicy rice dish. What we do is, I never cooked it personally, but I know the recipe, which I can explain in a few words. We separately cook the chicken. Then we can start with onion, frying onion in cooking oil, and then add the ginger and garlic and other spices and red chili or green chili. And then at the end we can add the chicken. We separately boil rice, and we in a separate pot. We have one layer of rice and then one layer of that chicken recipe thing, and then again one layer rice, one layer. So we fill that whole thing like this, and we put it for like 10 or 15 minutes with a very minor source of heat. So after 15-20 minutes of this layer thing, that dish is ready to eat. And it can be like, there can be a lot of variations of this, depending upon the amount of spices and type of spices. And you can even replace this chicken with fish also. In the coastal areas of subcontinent, they can have this dish with fish. So that, in that case, that is called fish biryani. So this is that recipe. Any question, I'll be happy to answer.
You eat it very often?
Whenever there is a gathering, family gathering especially, we have this kind of a necessary food item in the menu. And there is no need, because since it is mixed with the chicken thing already, so no need of any topping. It's the rice is already ready to eat. So it is very common, like you can ask any person belonging to Pakistan, India, or any country, he will definitely know this.
Next question, please.
I like naan.
Naan.
Yeah, is there
naan? There are different types of naan also. Naan is a kind of a wheat bread. The normal bread we have is like slices, but this is a big round piece of thick bread. Can be variable, thick or thin, depending upon the type, but primarily it is made of wheat. So just like rice, you people have as a main dish in Thailand, Southeast Asia, we have wheat as our main food item. You can say the subcontinent is the biggest wheat consuming part of the world. Naan, which is a wheat dish, is also a necessary item of every Pakistani or Indian meal. So what we do is that it itself has no particular taste. You have to dip it in some other chicken or some other vegetable dish. So it is like just like plain rice. You cannot eat without any other thing. Similarly, naan or the wheat bread, you also have to take something else to do in order to eat that. So we have like various types of naan depending upon the technique, how it is made, and depending upon the thickness, starting from the thickest one up till the very thin one. Our rice type is maybe indigo, because I never came across the Japanese rice type before coming to Japan. I was surprised to see the round grains and small ones. We have like, Pakistan is famous for producing long and thin rice. We call it basmati rice. And maybe it is indigo type. And they are not sticky. Like, unlike Japanese, our standard of judging a good rice is that it should not be sticky. It should be, it is opposite to Japan. Our standard is that it should be like separate, each grain should be separate. So they are considered good rice in our country. But I came across sticky rice first time when I came to Thailand, and I liked it with the mango cream.
Your food and Indian food
are almost same. There can be small variations, but overall the taste is same. So wherever there is some Indian restaurant in some other country, Pakistani people can go and have their own style. Similarly, if there is some Pakistani restaurant, Indian people and Bangladesh people and Nepal people can go and enjoy. Our food, our traditional food is different from Southeast Asia and Japan, and also from Western food. Okay, thank you.